guys, this is our female fighter segment where we are going to talk to some bold and fierce women. It's the first one that we're ever doing. I'm Kanika, and today I have someone called Sabrina with us.
Hi.
She's someone who wears a lot of hats, a woman I really respect, and she is part of our Femke squad as well. I'm going to let Sabrina tell you guys what she does, because there are a lot of things that she does, and one of it is that she's this really popular influencer, and she's an entrepreneur doing a lot of things. Sabrina, tell us what you're doing.
Alright, so I'm an entrepreneur, and I love to post pictures on Instagram, because that's what I like to do. And what else? Okay, what am I doing? I'm selling cosmetics, various kinds of cosmetics, also skincare products on my website, Cosmetic World, and I'm also selling shoes.
Cool.
And I'm doing a lot of things at the moment, and I'm also selling luxury loungewear and lingerie, which is on hold at the moment. It'll be back shortly. But basically, just going through every day, working, trying to build up my brands and also gain more exposure on myself and my companies, and hopefully one day I'll be better at what I'm doing. Yeah.
That is so inspiring. So guys, we are doing this because we want to bring some real stories of these women who have really been fighters, and we're going to be interviewing Sabrina to get to know her more. So we know there are a lot of followers that are out there who are Sabrina side, and we're going to come to know better about you. So I'm going to start with some of the questions, right? Tell us about the first time you got your period.
I wasn't prepared at all. I was still a kid.
Uh-huh.
I didn't know what was a period, of course. I wasn't prepared. My mother, I love you, mom, but she didn't prepare me, lah. Yeah, she didn't expect it. I didn't expect it.
Right. And so what age did you get it?
Secondary one.
So about 12, 11, 13?
Oh my god, I thought okay. 11 years old, primary 6. Secondary 1 above.
Around 12. 12, wow. Okay. And, you know, so what are your periods like every month?
It's really bad because, look at my body, it's like, I'm really thin, but my periods are very bad because it's always heavy,
uh-huh.
It's always painful,
uh-huh.
And it's very, it's really taxing on my body.
Right. Yeah. Any bad experiences you want to share with us?
I just get really moody and angry all the time when I'm having my period.
Right.
So it's really painful, and I just stay in bed.
Wow. I want to ask you something, right? Because you said you get moody and it gets very tired, right? There are so many women out there, Sabrina, who are trying to do so much stuff, right? They have these dreams and they want to be high achievers. And there's always these few things that take us women always down. They're trying to pull us down. And I feel, especially because my periods are bad as well, that Our health obviously is taking us down. What is the one message you want to give to these people, to these all inspiring, you know, young achievers?
Right.
When, let's say, I'm sure they have as worse periods as you do. So what is the one thing you want to tell them?
For me, I know I have this problem. Okay? So what I've learned, especially after working with you guys, it's not an ad, but it's just the truth, is to control the pain and to work through it. You know, and don't make it an excuse. Oh, of course I'm having my period, I don't want to go out. Go out. But make sure that you're prepared.
Right.
Take medication if you need to. Bring your sanitary pads with you.
Right.
Bring an extra pants with you. Like,
right.
Do something about it.
Yeah.
And with Fempiers, I believe that you can solve the problems.
Right.
It's really important to be prepared.
Right. I love what you said. Being prepared during your periods. It's so important. Now, I wanted to ask you one more personal question, right? Have you ever faced any disadvantages just because you're a female?
Of course. Men. Men. Some men, okay, not all men. Okay. Some men, they have this like assumption that if you're a woman, you're weak. You can't do a lot of things. I mean, physically, of course, we can't do a lot of things. But it doesn't stop us from doing other things that requires us to just use our brains. Like think. Emotionally, mentally, like there were times where people would be, oh, you're just a girl, you don't know anything. You're just a girl, you'll never have a business. You're just a girl, you'll never have a lot of interest in you. Because they think that people like to follow a man who's a leader. But what can girls be leaders?
Right.
I'm a leader, I own my business. I don't need, I need my father, but I don't need a man to be my partner.
Right.
I don't need a man to lead my business or
right.
take over my business. Because I can do it. I'm capable, you know?
Right.
And I guess a lot of guys need to learn that too. Like, it doesn't matter if you're a girl, as long as you have the capabilities, you have the characteristics of a leader, no matter what guy or girl, it's all yours.
Wow, I know what's fantastic what you said, that we're here today as an entrepreneur,
yeah.
And I should say as a serial entrepreneur, and you're here to support all other women.
Yes,
yes. I think that's the best part about it. And you know, now I always had these questions for influencers, right?
Okay.
And I'm not one myself, but I always get very excited when I'm around influencers. So now that I have this opportunity, I'm going to ask you two questions about influencers.
Okay.
Now we all know, oh my God. Every influencer's life is so glamorous, right? Instagram profile, a lot of followers, etc. Right? Tell me one thing. What's the best part about being an influencer?
Being very candid. Free stuff.
Uh-huh.
I mean, you get clothes. You get really nice goodie bags. You really get nice food. You
right.
get food. You also get accessories. You get all the latest stuff. So it's really exciting to see what's in your mailbox.
Right.
But I guess it's not always great.
Yeah.
Because there are also downsides to it.
Yeah.
Especially when it's in your DMs.
Yeah.
And hate comments.
Yeah.
And also people even texting you.
Yeah.
You know, like, oh, someone said this about you, blah, 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 after seeing your post. Or, I mean, the worst ones will be the anonymous DMs.
Right.
You know, all these anonymous profiles,
right.
they just create a profile to bring you down.
Right.
And they might even forget that they even have that profile. So it's like the hate that I'm getting, some of the hate that I'm getting from Instagram messages, which will try to ruin my mood, ruin my spirit.
Mm-hmm.
But you just gotta sometimes decline and block them.
Right.
Yeah.
Wow. So it's not at all glamorous like how we feel, right? I think all this has its downsides. And what are the expectations that people have for you? Does it ever take a toll on you?
Yeah. Whenever I start posting, maybe I have something to post every day.
Yeah.
People will look forward to it, right?
Yeah.
But if I stop,
yeah.
they might think there's something wrong with me.
Yeah.
Because sometimes you just need a break.
Yeah.
I just need to detox.
Right.
That's one.
Yeah.
But what if you post too much?
Yeah.
There might be even a problem for some people because
yeah.
nothing's ever good enough for people.
I agree. Right. So, and do you ever feel that pressure of living
yes.
to everyone's
like,
expectations?
You gotta always be perfect. You always have to have a lot of makeup on when you go out. And so that when people be like, she doesn't look like that.
Right.
Yeah. And I'm like, why can't I just be myself? Why must I put on a lot of makeup just to go for a nice dinner?
I agree.
Like, it's just nearby.
You bring a very good point of authenticity and that you still remain genuine
yeah.
and showing people and telling people.
I think also people got to understand that we have a life.
Uh-huh.
It's not like every day I want to put on a lot of makeup.
Right.
Yeah, just accept me for who I am, my personality. Like me for what I'm inside. Yeah.
Love that part. And I'm going to end on a very positive note with you over here. There's so many girls out there who are following you, that look up to you. What is it one thing you want to tell us?
Just be yourself. Don't try hard to be someone else. If this is how you are, how you look, how you dress, stay that way. If you want to change something about yourself, make sure you're doing it for you. Don't be changing for someone else because they will never appreciate it.
Right.
You gotta appreciate yourself. Okay, love yourself. Be happy. Be happy with how you look. And be confident.
Right.
Don't allow anyone to say anything bad about you. Don't allow all these DMs or hates. Know, all these comments to bring you down, because at the end of the day, the people around you are the ones who love you, like your parents, your best friends, they're the ones who appreciate you. Just make sure that these people are the ones that are happy with you, so that
you
can have a happy life.
Love that. Great. And guys, now we're going to play something fun with Sabrina, and it's called the Rapid Fire. So it's a rapid fire with our female fighter, Sabrina. So you have to be very quick,
all right?
Very candid, but most of it very honest.
Okay.
So we're gonna start. One. Describe Sabrina in one word.
Bold.
What Netflix show are you currently obsessed with?
The Good Wife.
Oh, okay. Why do you decide to work with feminists?
because you guys are amazing. I love what you guys are doing. And there's a very good message behind Pampers and everyone who's being charitable and wants to help one another and most importantly, woman empowerment.
Love it, love it. Tell us about an embarrassing period situation you've been in.
Okay, years ago, I was walking down Orchard Road and I was wearing white pants. Uh-huh. And I didn't know I was going to have my period and it was wet and gross.
Okay.
But I didn't know, I thought it was just water. Mm-hmm. And then someone tapped me on my shoulders and said that there's, I stained my pants and it was a guy. Mm-hmm. So I cut the shopping experiences for the day. I went home.
Oh wow. Okay. Who are your favorite female role models?
Naomi Campbell, Olivia Campbell.
Any reason?
Olivia Campbell, fashion.
Uh-huh.
Fashion sense is amazing. Naomi Campbell, sorry, I almost like choked. I love her attitude.
Yeah. Okay, cool. So, Sabrina, if you could only take three things to a deserted island, what would they be and why?
Concealer, because I need concealer on my face. body foam, so I can use it to cleanse my face, cleanse my body, and even use it for my hair.
Cool.
And lastly, sanitary pads, because somebody can do it and
can't live it on, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And have you heard any rumors about yourself?
Yeah!
Like what?
The really bad ones.
Uh-huh.
That I'm bitchy.
We all heard.
But I'm not!
And the last one. What's the best thing about being an influencer that people might want?
Going for nice events, beautiful dinners, and meeting new people.
Amazing. Yeah. Thank you so much, Sabrina.
No problem.
We love to have you here, and I can't tell you how positive a person you are.
Thank you so much for being with us.